intelligent, innocent, intense, selfish, stylish, straightforward, and eccentric. These are some words people have used to describe me. When I was asked to describe myself in three words, I struggled to choose three quintessential words. It was my first day in a new company, in a new profession, 4 years ago. I was filling up an HR form. Full of life? No, that's not one word. Vitality? No, that's not an adjective. Vital? I don't think that means the same thing. Then I thought, this is just a form that will get filed. It doesn't matter what I write. Little did I know, those three words, along with my photograph, would go into an email sent to all staff saying, please welcome Raghunandan Damle, who joins us today as an interior designer. He describes himself as vital, balanced, and creative. Good evening, Toastmasters, and welcome guests.
Good evening.
I was born in Mumbai on Ram Navami. I would have been named Ram, but that name was already taken by my cousin's son. Raghunandan was the next option, but again, I had an uncle named Raghu, and besides, my parents didn't like the name. Still, they named me Raghunandan and called me Nandan. In school, college, and office, people called me Raghu and some called me Damle, which made me feel like many people in one. So I will be grateful and feel more like myself if, like my family, you all call me Nandan. By the time I was 5 years old, people observed I was articulate and had an eye for beauty. I got into my first high school, Green Lawns, by answering just one question in the interview. The principal, an attractive lady with green eyes, wearing green eyeshadow, asked me to show her something green in the room. I looked straight at her and said, "Your eyes." When I heard my aunt complaining about her husband, I said to her, "Kaku, why don't you divorce him?" She was aghast. My father was a naval architect from Maharashtra. My mother is from Coorg. I grew up speaking English at home. My father died suddenly of a cardiac arrest when I was 9 years old. I was too small to be affected much by it, though my life took a turn as I moved to Bangalore in 1982. With my mother and elder sister to live closer to my mother's family. In school, I was top ranker in class and captain of my house. I excelled at acting in plays on stage and TV and played the guitar. Holidays were spent in the company of my cousins, often at my aunt's coffee estate. An avid reader of books, I was an extremely active, adventurous, mischievous boy, always up to something. When people ask me what I wanted to be when I grew up, I would say, rich, so I can be free to do whatever I want. I enjoyed my childhood so much, I did not want to grow up. Perhaps it was compensation for years of misery to follow. By the time I was in pre-university, I had dabbled in painting, poetry, various arts and crafts, and had started growing my own bonsai collection. My marks went steadily down. I decided to study architecture. When I learned the profession does not pay well, I changed to computer science engineering. That choice almost killed me. 2 years later, I wanted to drop out of college and attempted suicide. It was the most difficult period of my life. I took an extra year to complete engineering in the second class. After that, my cousins in America suggested I go there for higher studies. I felt like saying to them, thank you, if you will write the exams for me, I will do it. Otherwise, forget it. I started on a salary of 3,000 rupees and quickly rose in my software career. Work took me to foreign countries, Canada and Australia. It did not give me creative fulfillment or freedom. So 11 years later, I quit and explored other business opportunities. I failed and became bankrupt. Forced to go back to work, I decided to change my profession to interior design. Through a reference, I got into a leading architecture company in Bangalore as an apprentice without a salary. Today, 4 years later, I'm head of hospitality projects at the same company. I now belong to three clubs. The Happily I'm Married Club, Vriksha Bonsai Study Circle, and now Bangalore Toastmasters. Thank you for accepting me into this awesome club. Over to you.